Welcome to Second Earth Alternative. I don't know what to say. It appears that our worst fears has been confirmed. The coronavirus is not only spreading, it is accelerating extremely quickly. We had suspected in our last episode that it was possible that this coronavirus had mutated and had acquired a human-to-human transmission ability. It appears that that is the case, as the experts have been indicating that there is no possibility that this virus could have spread this quickly had this supposed mutation not taken place. So they're not even calling it coronavirus anymore. They're calling it N-coronavirus, standing for new coronavirus, a new strand to which there is no antidotes and to which researchers have never seen before. As of yesterday, as of the last episode that I posted, we had 17 confirmed cases. According to this article by the Washington Post, titled Coronavirus Live Update, China's leader warns of accelerating spread of virus. China's leader Xi Jinping warned Saturday of an accelerating spread of the coronavirus, adding to worries about the scope of a health crisis that has claimed at least 56 lives and triggered emergency health measures in cities across China. Now, last time we reported, it was 17. So in a matter of 24 hours, this virus has become three times more deadly. Though the life total right now might seem somewhat low, it is actually very concerning because of the, how do you say it, the exponential nature of bacterial growth. So I'm going to get back to this in a second. I just want to show you what the BBC is telling us in this latest update, which was given less than an hour ago. China coronavirus spread is accelerating, Xi Jinping warns. Now, the president of China, Xi Jinping, was quoted saying this is a grave situation. The coronavirus has killed at least 42 people and infected some 1,400 since its discovery in a city of Wuhan. Meanwhile, UK-based researchers have warned of a real possibility that China will not be able to contain the virus. Travel restrictions have come in place in several affected cities. From Sunday, private vehicles will be banned from central districts of Wuhan, the source of the outbreak. So we're talking about a city of 16 million people to which there's no more plane travels, no more trains. And now we're talking about personal vehicles being banned. So these people are being essentially quarantined. Look, when I woke up this morning, I started checking my tweets and the tweets associated with coronavirus, and I was seeing what people were reporting from Wuhan. It looked like a movie. I mean, it just didn't look real. I don't know if you guys have seen some of these videos. So yeah, let's just take a look real quick. I'm gonna be honest with you, I don't think I've ever seen an individual just be put into a box like that. It's very concerning. I wanted to show you guys the nature of this virus and what is actually happening, because it says here, symptoms seem to start with a fever followed by dry cough, and then after a week led to shortness of breath and some patients needing hospital treatment. There is no specific cure or vaccine. So what I'm seeing here is a pathogen that seems to be dormant for weeks before symptoms arrive that maybe or maybe not you might need a hospital visit. So what I'm trying to hint here is that not everybody who's going to acquire the virus is going to go to the hospital. So the chances of this virus transmitting and the chances of authorities being able to actually quarantine all the possible outlets of the virus, well, it seems pretty low just based on the nature of the virus being dormant for about a week or so. Now, what really made me how do you say it, kind of sweat it out a little bit, is this new information that their calculations estimate each infected person is passing it on to an average of 2.5 other people. So here it says there are now 1,372 confirmed cases across China, though most are concentrated in the province closest to Hubei, okay? But according to this article, which gives us some live updates, as of 12:50, there were more than 1,400 people that have been infected, 42 that had died. As of 3:55, more than 1,700 people had been infected, and in the span of 1 hour, they had confirmed that it was 1,900 people. So either this thing is spreading very fast, or the initial numbers that they gave us for the amount of people that are infected was unusually low. Either way, it's not a good scenario. And when you're talking about a city of 60 million people that are being quarantined, we got American citizens there, people from Ireland, people from the UK who teach English in Wuhan, and they're not able to come home right now. These people are essentially being quarantined in China. And look, I don't know if you guys heard about this story. I first heard about this from a viewer, but according to this links right here, it says 14 people in the UK tested for the new strain. So it has already reached Europe, and 14 people with a transmission rate of 2.5 per person, that is a recipe for disaster. It seems like it could transmit very quickly. And what I mean by this is, if you look up here, it says Wuhan woman who cheated checks found in France. And this is a story that was brought to my attention by the viewer. And it says here, coronavirus, Chinese embassy in Paris finds woman who cheated checks. So apparently this woman had felt the symptoms of cold, felt the symptoms of fever, and essentially decided to take tablets to cheat the symptoms to be able to travel back to Paris. And I just have to ask straight up, is it a coincidence that Paris now has 3 new cases? It looks like this thing is spreading, and it looks like there's no way it's going to be able to be contained in China, given the nature that this virus stays dormant for so long. And this is just the beginning stages. We don't know if this virus is going to continue to mutate. Hopefully it will mutate in such a way that it will snuff itself out, as it happened with the last SARS virus. But obviously there's no guarantee of that. That's just would be wishful thinking based on the fact that it may have happened by mere chance in the past. I also want to mention about this incredible coincidence that the sea market, the Huanan sea market, where the virus apparently started, well, it was only, you know, from our calculations from the previous episode, 16 miles away from the actual containment lab that they were studying the same type of variant strands of SARS. So the question is this some huge coincidence that a lab, of which there's only a handful in all of Asia, suddenly has a virus outbreak only a few miles away? So it says here in the very end, a study published in the Lancet Medical Journal Friday confirmed the current outbreak is a new form of coronavirus, which is closest to the SARS-related coronaviruses found in Chinese horseshoe bats. So if this is true, then definitely the idea that the virus originated from the seafood market, that has a lot of merits. But here's what I found kind of interesting, and I'm not an expert, so I would love feedbacks from people who have a deeper understanding of biology, if this is possible. But it says here, some scientists believe another species was involved in transmitting the disease to humans, but no consensus has yet emerged to which animal, with theories ranging from snakes to mink. So I guess what the analysis of the virus was indicating is that this coronavirus was a new mutation that was an adaptation of two different variations of coronaviruses coming in contact with each other in a given host. Now, is it possible, given the coincidence of the lab, that some employee at the lab had some perhaps dormant version of the disease without realizing that he had been contaminated, and then upon going to the seafood market and eating the bats, which in themselves have their own variation of coronavirus, could this be the factor that allowed the viruses to essentially mutate. Like I said, I'm not an expert, just wanted to put that out there for anybody to comment on who might have a better understanding of this topic. Lastly, if I know the cases are only ranging in a few thousands, but if it's true that this virus is increasing at a rate of 2.5 per person, you know, what concerns me the most is, like I said earlier, is the exponential nature of this virus. So if the cases continue to double every day as the trend has seems to be happening, and given this effect is not due to underreporting but to the actual growth of the virus itself, well, let me show you something in terms of how quickly this thing can actually grow. Pull out my dandy calculator over here, and I just want to show you, let's say we have 1280 cases, okay, and let's say it doubles every day. Well, let's see how long it would take for it to start reaching global pandemic levels. So each time I multiply by 2, that's another day, essentially. So we're already in the hundreds of thousands. Millions. Tens of millions. Hundreds of millions. 1.3 billion people in a matter of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. In a matter of 20 to 21 days, a contagion, a virus that spreads or doubles and starts with a number of 1,280, will reach 1.3 billion infected people in less than a month, in 2/3 of a month, according to this calculation. So that's what it means to have a virus that can spread at an exponential rate. Now, look, they're doing a lot of efforts to try to keep this at bay. There are a lot of travel bans, very strict travel bans, which is going to be good at helping the transmission rate. So hopefully it's not going to be doubling every day. Otherwise, we're going to be in a lot of trouble. But that is the update for today. Honestly, hope for the best. And yeah, just I pray for all the viewers and their loved ones, and wish you all the best. This is Felipe Osorio, signing out.